Okay. What are the what is the likelihood that we're almost done with this game now? I wonder. Wow. Always the preemptive buttons. Huh, I did not realize that attack actually did damage. Also, why keep pressing on the stupid... excuse me. Trying not to sneeze here and it just immediately happens.
Oh look, it's those girls again.
Can it, Hasabe? It has not been a good day. Rude.
So rude. What are you girls doing here? Sunbathing?
In front of a Yakuza building?
The sun is perfect here. Yeah, don't you know that?
Oh wait, I forgot. You're all pale and pasty and... We don't got time for this! Step aside. We need to find our boyfriends.
Your boyfriends? Could they be any more clueless?
What's so funny?
Kunio loves me.
Riki is mine.
Do you honestly think they'd give a pair of...
Can we just crush their skulls already?
Why does it matter what time it is?
I don't believe it. Kunio, he likes me.
Sure he does.
And Riki is totes my BF.
Go ahead and ask him.
Oh, we will. Tonight. Later, losers.
Well, whenever they have these lock screens, the sound gets all fucked up where it doesn't really make any noise at the edge of the screen. Again, I wish I had some attack that would just let me ignore some of their attacks and just break out of a groove. Oh, now I know why this feels so strange. It's because I wasn't using this controller to play this game last time. Oi. My thumb was defaulting to the position where the D-pad normally is on this other controller. Switch it up. God, how do I forget this stuff? Okay, here we go. This feels better. Well, that was fucking fast. Died already. Where do I want to go? That's right, I can wall jump. Did I not go up there?
Hasabe's lying, right, Misako?
What? Obviously. Those jerks have been jealous of us since we were little kids. Now come on! Let's defeat this army of Yakuza soldiers and get our boyfriends back!
Really? Nothing I can do about that. Really? Can I even block that? I can't. Okay, cool. That's such a worthless move, I swear. God, all the moves in this game are so slow and they have no reach. Not to mention they don't cover much in the way of, different lanes. Really? I don't know what the hell they did that hit me out of the fucking throw animation, but that's fucking great. I'm barely 10 minutes into the stream. I'm already complaining about this game. I was in the middle of an attack animation. Those guys even got hit by it. And you're telling me, whatever. I really wish they couldn't guard my special moves, because that's like the one thing I have that might be helpful. What's this? Just like some stove burner? Just sitting there? Did he move with me as he was swinging? Because that's some fucking garbage. Ah. I fucking swear to God. There's so much recovery lag on just getting your attack blocked when there really shouldn't be. It feels fucking awful. I can never time a parry there. Stop picking things up and just hit the fucker. Note to self, never use that button. Where do I go from here? Okay, let's get back to it. Sorry about the interruption. Let's keep going up. What the hell happened there visually? Well, no invincibility on throws. That's so fun. Again, I hate that they can block that shit. Like, this is one of the reasons why having a freeform throw and a beat-em-up is so nice, because when they start turtling like that, you can just get around it by throwing them. And it sucks to have a throw feature that is so fundamentally garbage. Still no parries. Wow, I was nowhere near that. Look where I am, look where I am. Get this out of here. I don't think they mean it literally when they say money laundering. I don't know why they didn't come out when I pressed the button the first time. Again, collision detection is so great. Button didn't do anything. It's this thing again. What is this? You're telling me that wasn't even a necessary way to go? There we go, I got an actual useful assist. Oh, you're fucking kidding me. I'm too fast for that, huh? But I'm too slow for that. Dude! Get out of here.
Hold it! You're not allowed up here.
We need to get inside that penthouse.
Nobody gets inside except...
Please don't ask us to guess your dog's name.
Or buy you a golden cat.
What? No, I was gonna say no one gets inside except the boss. And it's my job to keep hooligans like you from entering.
Hooligans? Yeesh, that's judgy.
Yeah, especially coming from a Yakuza henchman holding an Uzi.
This is my job.
Not a very good one.
Thank you. 1 hour later.
Okay, I'm back. Sorry about the delay. Something came up and I had to take care of it. Anyway, hello. What you up to? Alright, where am I? Wait, what are those exclamation points I passed over?
Let's find those explosives and blow things up! Only the penthouse door.
Is this that explosive thingy?
Yeah, now be careful you don't blow us up.
What explosive thingy? I'm not seeing anything. Hey, Billy, how you doing? Oh, what? I don't actually get to see the thing, I just gotta go there? Oh, I fucking hate this. Well, at least I landed here, so I didn't have to do the jump again. Hasta la brada. Can't recover from that too quickly. Alright, where am I going? Next room over. Through the vent. Nothing here? It says there's something here. Oh, there it is. I see it.
Got another one.
Yeah. Let me out, please. You know, I don't get why you'd put explosives in your own building.
Another explosive. Let's go.
But I've never been in a casino.
Kyoko.
No special move, even though I did it very, very distinctly. The tracking! Did you see that? Stop. I was fucking standing up. There really needs to be a better indicator for when these guys will get up, because trying to grapple somebody when someone's down and beating them is inherently risky alone, but then when you don't have invincibility during grapples, it's even worse, because those guys can just decide to get up whenever they fucking feel like it. And I fucking hate it. No invincibility. I like how I mash jabbed there and nothing came out. That's fantastic. Get this out of my fucking sight. Thank you. God, I fucking hate this. Don't pick her up, fucking, I hate this game's combat feel so much. The parry never works. The throws suck. Like, everything that's supposed to make this work just doesn't. Fuck you. Fucking, you can't rely on them to stay fucking down. Nothing. Ah, fuck. Turn around. There's a reason why I'm holding the right direction. This game has shit controls. I don't know how, but it just managed. You don't get lower body invincibility on jumping. You don't get invincibility with special moves. This game fucking gives you fuck all. And yet they still imagine that, oh, this is gonna be fun. With the shittiest jab in the world and terrible normals. Also, making me platform in a beat-em-up, like, I'll forgive some older games for doing this, but in a modern game, fuck you. Get this out of here. Fuck, I hate the pickups.
Explosives acquired. Okay, explosives planted. Let's get the heck out of here.
And the guy's just standing there. And now he's dead. Weren't you helping us?
You're Sabu?
He's prettier than I expected.
Silence! My name is Sabuko, daughter to the great Sabu. And head of my father's empire while he is indisposed.
On the toilet?
I think she means prison.
Before I kill you both, I'm curious why you felt the need to storm my tower and defeat all my men.
And women. We noticed you got a lot of girl yakuza too.
Which is seriously cool.
Totally. Girl power!
I'm sorry I asked. Prepare to die!
Wait! We're here looking for our boyfriends!
Kunio and Ricky. Did you take them?
What would I possibly want with a pair of high school boys?
Oh, crap. Guess we better look somewhere else now.
I hope the next place has more shopping.
You two aren't going anywhere.
What, you're gonna call your guards on us? In case you haven't noticed, they're all beat up.
Yeah, we did that. For love.
I don't need anyone to fight my fights for me. I hope you've enjoyed your lives up to this point. They're about to end.
What's going on here? Your gimmick is you call your friends. Oh, I see now. I can't cancel when I get blocked for some reason. I hate that I can't cancel a blocked normal. With anything, it fucking sucks. It feels so counterintuitive to what these games should allow you to do. Oh, that fucking hit detection. So I'm just gonna do that to dodge you? Fucking hell. Really? Get out of here, bitch. Well, another phase? Okay. All you did was call more friends. Really, is this it? Again, can't cancel on block. Fun. Thank you. It's like Wave 4 took a genre of games that I like and made it not fun to play.
Impossible! Defeated by a pair of schoolgirl deviants! How?
Just because we're young.
And cute.
Don't mean we can't tear down this whole town to get our boyfriends back.
Wretched little girls! You should respect power when you see it!
You may have mystical tattoo creatures.
And a really sharp sword.
But that's nothing compared to the power we have!
And that is...
You wanna tell her?
Let's do it together. The power of... This was a bad idea, wasn't it?
Not our smartest plan. Maybe if we twist our bodies just as we land, we can...
Hey, we're not dead.
No, but we're gonna be sore tomorrow.
I wonder what happened to that lady we... Ah!
What is it, Kyoko?
Oh, man, you were right, Ricky. A trip to the spa is just what we needed.
I agree, Kunio. It is relaxing.
Huh?
Ah, it's girls! Look away!
The spa's for men only.
Kunio! You big dummy, we've been looking all over for you!
We thought you were kidnapped, Ricky Poo!
Ah, jeez. It's those crazy girls again. What were their names?
No idea. Come on, let's get out of here.
Yeah, maybe Hasabe and Mommy are still up.
You're telling me this entire game's story was a big old nothing sandwich? Well, I feel thoroughly disrespected. Way 4 took a genre of games I like and makes it not fun to play, and then the entire time I'm playing the game was completely pointless and way too long. How much fun is that? I mean, if you want to play this game, feel free to do so, but Jesus fucking Christ, this is not fun. Ow. Get out, this stupid fucking game. It feels so garbage for a fucking beat-em-up. Like, I know I had similar complaints with Turtles, but not only did Turtles patch some of the things I wanted into the game, but at least the game had the decency of making it so that when enemies do guard your stuff, you can still continue your strings. Whether or not they're safe or not is completely up to you. But everything about this game is fucking garbage. Like, even Double Dragon, that used similar mechanics to this, felt a lot better to play. Because the jabs were actually faster. The enemies couldn't just fucking retaliate in the middle of your recovery because it was fast enough. And the grapples were actually good, you know? Granted, not a lot of enemies would actually challenge you on your grapples, but when you did get challenged, you had the ability to throw, which would give you invincibility to get through a particularly dangerous ambush. But fucking Christ, everything about River City Girls feels bad. So what now? The same thing we do every time we finish a game, puppy. Time to open the Excel sheet. Here we go. Eh, you get this. At least Shantae was some fun. It's a sequel to a series that I like, and it's garbage. So this took, first of all, my biggest complaint about this game is it took 7 hours. That's way too damn long for a beat-em-up like this. Even the Kunio-kun games that happened more recently on like the 3DS were not as long. Maybe 3 hours tops. And that's because the game has RPG elements and some progression. That's totally fine because the Kunio-kun games on the 3DS were fun. I liked them. Was it worth it? No. Would I play it again? Only if I was begged to. Or paid. Preferably both. Oh boy. I don't understand it. I just don't. How does WayForward make one of the best Double Dragon games and then proceeds to make this? It's like they don't actually know how to make games like this. They just got lucky. Fuck, man. This is the antithesis. This is the antithesis to everything that a beat-em-up should be. The jabs are too slow. You can't combo out of blocked moves. You have no invincibility on wake up. Especially against throws. Specifically against throws. The specials feel bad. Offer no actual reward for using them. Damage, invincibility, or otherwise. The weapons are a pain to navigate around. Same with picking up people. And no way to turn any of it off. I am goddamn annoyed. Like, this game makes me so bitter that I feel like I'm on the verge of taking it out on somebody, and I don't want to. Ugh, fuck, man. Like, is this how all modern beat-em-ups are gonna be? They're just gonna be, like, 8 to 10 hour ordeals that just feel shitty to play in the long run? Like, what the fuck's wrong with these guys? Like, I would rather play Shredder's Revenge. Shredder's Revenge is a good game, even if it has a lot of the flaws that this game shares. And I complain about Shredder's Revenge because the jabs are so slow and weak, and the game is too fucking long, but it felt good to play it because at least in the end, they buffed throws to actually be useful for defensive maneuvers as well as offensive ones. They also made it so that the jabs are differentiated from one another. So if you have one character you don't like the jab of because it's too slow or it's too short, you have other options as far as characters go. Each character plays differently from one another. The special moves do something. Also, jumping is a great defensive maneuver in Turtles, whereas jumping in River City Girls does fucking nothing. Like, even if you jump really badly in River City Ransom, you could get jabbed out of the air, but all that would happen is you'd fall down. Like, whatever. And you'd have to be, like, really close to the same timing as they're hitting you. Because otherwise, something that jumps tend to do in beat-em-ups is that they make your lower half of your body invincible while you're jumping. Because it's really helpful for defensive play. It can't be abused, of course, because jump attacks tend to be very weak and knocked down. And you can't control the situation from the air as well as you can from the ground. But jump attacks were an option if you were getting swarmed a little bit, you know? And again, there is also countermeasures against jumping as a defensive option, with attacks that are specifically made to hit people who are jumping. But jumping was an option if you were getting swarmed by just the grunts. This game feels like everything is a grunt, and there's no defensive options except for the block, which is not omnidirectional, and the parry is either too specific, too strict, I don't know, I could never get the parry to work. The parry is offered as a feature in River City Girls, where if you tap guard at the exact right time, you can block an enemy attack, push them off of you, and put them into a brief stun state. And I found out you can do it to protect yourself from, like, attack strings, but the timing is so particular that it's almost ridiculously difficult to pull off. Like, the one thing about having a manual guard button in a beat-em-up is that it already just, like, feels pretty bad to have, especially if you're completely immobile while doing so. But then on top of that, you can't really turn around while guarding, from what I experimented with. Even worse is if you're trying to turn around after a string of attacks in River City Girls, sometimes it just doesn't happen. Like, one time while I was climbing the tower, I was, like, beating some guy up in the left corner and he was done for, and someone approached me from behind, right? So I was holding right on the D-pad, waiting for my animation to finish because they're so damn long. And then as soon as I was like, okay, now I'm turned around in my head, I can hold right and press B to do my cannon drill. But instead, I got dragon kicks in place facing to the left. And that's fucking annoying. You know? Like, that is not a fun game. I don't know why I count on modern beat-em-ups to be anything but garbage. I'm going to also add this game to the bad games category and remove it from the backlog. So, woohoo! Let's see. Like, technically, it's styled after an arcade game, but I dare not keep... I'm very much on the fence about taking it off of the arcade list, because this is, like, this is a shitty beat-em-up. Like, I bet right now I can just jump onto Steam and find a better beat-em-up right away. Oh, hey, look, it's River City Saga Three Kingdoms. I wonder if that plays any better. Oh, look, Double Dragon Neon. That's automatically way better. Capcom Belt Action Collection, yep. Those games are difficult, but they all feel way better to play. Like, I don't get why it's so difficult to make a beat-em-up that doesn't feel like trash. Like, this is a formula that was mastered back in the mid-90s. Did we just forget all the lessons that beat-em-ups taught us? Like, there are modern beat-em-ups coming out these days that are actually pretty decent. Like, what was it? I have it. It's like a Fight of Rage or some shit. Let me find it. Fight and Rage. There it is. You want to see what a good beat-em-up looks like? Because this one plays a lot better, like a million times better. And the nice thing about it is it's relatively inexpensive. It's smaller than 300 megabytes. It's got local multiplayer. It's pretty damn good. Okay, so it's not decently inexpensive. It's like 20 bucks. But when it goes on sale, it's at least 50% off. But it's fun. It's flashy. It feels good to play. And it doesn't drag on for like 10 hours on one playthrough. It's like tops an hour and a half. You know? Oh, and best of all the attacks string together a lot better. A lot better. Here, let me just boot this baby up real quick. Look at that. Already it's like, hey, we recognize that this is an arcade genre, so let's do a little bit of, like, passing reference to the old boot-up sequences of Capcom arcade games. Oh, look at this. The UI actually looks okay. That's something I didn't complain about enough. The UI looks like fucking garbage. Okay, let's see what kind of costumes I can unlock. This is locked, apparently. I need to beat the game on a higher difficulty level, I assume. Morrigan color. Yeah, these are all things you can unlock just for fun. Then you got stuff for, like, other characters. I think you can unlock more characters to play too, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, here we go. Extra characters. Huge cat? Oh, that sounds fun. Oh, these are literally the pigs from Battletoads. Yeah. What the fuck? This guy reminds me of the boxer characters from, Streets of Rage. But it's dressed up like a Bruce Lee wannabe. Oh, it's a Tenku, or a Kenku. It's just a crow. Yeah, let's buy this guy. He's purple. These are the kickboxers from Streets of Rage, like, literally. This is Linda from Double Dragon. Already this game looks cooler. Now let's actually play the damn game. Oh, this is just a tutorial, right? Yeah, I can figure it out. Oh, look at that. Already this feels great. You want to play as a fursona or a jiggle physics with hair? Jiggle physics with hair is usually pretty fun. Like, already this game feels fun. Don't even have to fucking wait for it. Look at that. The moment I get surrounded, it feels great to have a move that spends health, but gets me out of trouble. River City Girls doesn't let me do that. And honestly, I know Kunio-kun games generally don't let you do that either, but at least it feels better to get in those situations and fight out of it, because at least you have a guard button that's, you know, technically, it's a control limitation that makes it feel better to play, because the guard button is also tied to your attack buttons. But it worked better. Like, I don't see how you could mess that up. You could guard on spot while moving. Ah, shit. Ah, damn, that was me messing up. Ah, damn, I messed up the combo anyway. Oh no, I was almost at the hell, fuck. Fucking them bison bullshit. Get out of here. You know what? Let's get even closer to the source material, huh? Let's close this down. Let's go grab actual River City Ransom. Do-do-do. Over here. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. Because actual River City Ransom at least feels better. Let's see. R-I-R-O-R-A-R-E. There it is. Let's play actual River City Ransom. Skip cutscenes. Look at that. I don't have to worry about accidentally picking people up because these guys don't have a fucking million health. And then when I want to pick them up, I can. Also, having a punch and kick button makes this a lot easier too, by the way. Because the kick button picks people up and throws them, whereas the punch button does nothing but punch. Or swing a weapon. So I don't have to worry about accidentally picking people up in the middle of a fucking combo because it's not dedicated to the same damn button. Ow. That does hurt, though. Ow, fuck you. Hey, fuck you. Where the hell did your friend go? See, look at that. The guard button is set to the same button as the attack, the punch button. So if you need a spot block, you can do so. Again, it's not omnidirectional, but at least it works. Ah, shit. Ow, fuck. Again, block on the same button. Instead of being a dedicated thing. Like, I'm dying faster, but at least I can actually fight back. And actually make use of the guard. Alright, I'm running away because I need to heal. This was the bookstore. Yeah, this is where you learn your skills. So, Dragon Feet is actually good in this game. I do want it, but right now I will not pick it up. Because I still need to heal. Let's do cheaper sushi. Prawn? I think this one gives me just stamina. No, strength. Look at that. Look how easy it is to increase your stats in this game. One more, just because I want to hit things harder. Alright, main menu, and let's go. Ow, fuck. It somehow it turns out that the limitation of controls actually makes this a lot easier to play. Would you imagine that? Oh, right. I had to come back here later because there's a boss here, but right now it's pretty clear. Wow. Fuck you. Get out of here. Throwing them seems to actually do damage in this game, which is great. Okay, you can have your friend. I don't want him. Dashing attacks actually feel good if you actually space them well. Ow. I will say the immediate predictive attacks is still a bit of a problem, but that's whatever. Everyone has shit range in this game. How much money do I have? That's not here. Huh, do I actually have to walk into a store to look at my money? Let's stick to the cheaper swoosh. Let's get eel. What does this do? Oh yeah, I can use more defense. Mm-mm-mm. I think that actually gave me another unit of health, too, which is great. See, this is a game that's more conducive to grinding because you get small rewards just for healing yourself and shit. And it doesn't feel like it's a fucking pain in the dick to fight. Because every enemy doesn't have a bajillion HP. Ow. I did that to myself. Like, this actually feels fun. Hold still. Now you better run. Like, I don't have to move. And this is great. I'm having a great time. You know, another thing I may have realized just now about this older game is there's a limitation to how many enemies can be on screen at once. Because it's an older NES game, I think there can only be like 3 or 4 sprites on screen at one time. Oh, where's the bookstore in this section? Is that it? Let's see. No, this is the pharmacy. Eh, I don't care. These could be good, though, for later. Save it as a .fla. Flata. Look at that. I can block that shit on reaction. Oh, it's Moose! Oh shit, I'm gonna get my ass whooped. Ah, damn it, he got me. That was my fault. I didn't block. Where did I... Oh, I'm back over here. Yeah, Moose is like the first boss, but he's not that tough, just as long as you don't, you know, block with your face. Well, that's another thing about guarding enemies in River City Girls is that guarding enemies just don't move and they just kind of stay there. In this game, you actually push enemies who are blocking back. So you feel like you're making progress against them even if you can't break through their defense. And that's helpful because you can actually push them into bad situations on purpose. Like, say, if they're blocking in front of a pothole, you can push them into the pothole and kill them. Ow, fucker. Oh, you gonna sit there and guard? Alright. Ow. Wasn't expecting that. Oh, you better run. I'm gonna get ya! Like, I'm more bound to fail in this game just because of how much more challenging it is. But at the same time, it doesn't feel bad to fail in this game like it does River City Girls. Okay. I gotta save up to buy a Dragon Feet, though, because that's gonna be a huge boon. Unlike it is in River City Girls. Ow. I ran into the mailbox. That was my bad. Oh yeah, jump attacks. The jump attacks are helpful in this game. I should be using them, like this. You can air guard. That's something I completely forgot about. I will admit that you can kind of abuse the enemy's AI by protecting weapons. But you know what? It gives you a distinct advantage in a bad situation where you might be outnumbered. Because the AI is always going to try and pick up weapons whenever they're on the ground. So abusing that, you can easily control the fight, even if you don't have tools to do so yet. Literal tools being the answer here. Look at this guy, he's just like gonna fuck off and run away, isn't he? Oh, look at that, his AI kicking in. Oops, I ran into that thing. Oh yeah, one more thing. You can actually use weapons to hit people on the ground in this game, unlike in River City Girls. I wish I could have done it so badly when I was playing earlier. Ugh. I don't have a lot of money, but I'm just gonna check. I'm actually curious as to what the rest of these sushis do. They're cheap and give low stats, but it's worth taking a look at. Weapon? Ah, that's worthless. I don't use weapons in this game, at least not very often. Punch? Okay, punch is good. But it's only 1 point of punch, so it's not the best. Strength is usually tied to your health and your stamina. Stamina being how much you can, stamina is like your exhaustion meter, and if your exhaustion meter reaches zero, you won't get up after losing all your health. But if you have some stamina left, you can get up after losing all your health. It's kind of like a secondary health bar in a way. Yeah, you better run. There's some really good food items in the early game that you can get that are really, really handy for powering up. Oh, that's how you see your money. Okay, okay. I forgot about that. If I can beat Moose right now, I might be able to get a good amount of money, actually. Oh, fuck you. There we go, got him. Hey, stop already, you're hurting me. Eat shit, Moose. Alright, let's see what I can buy here that might restore my health. Oh, here's another bookstore. What the hell is... Oh, these are stat-raising books. Okay, I was like, what the hell are these? Comic Times, I think, is Punch, right? Nothing. I'm done. Belongings... Weapon, defense, and willpower. Willpower! Okay, willpower is the thing you use to get up after you've lost all your health. Oops. No, 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 no. Get out. Shewale. Onion soup, please. Oh, hey, look at that. Oh, thank you, puppy. That was fast. I was about to say, oh, hey, look who that is. Who is this? Is this, oh, this is Roxy. I don't know what her Japanese name is because I've never played this with the English translation. You know, barring the localization, of course. I think there's a boss directly north of me, but he's usually pretty tough and I don't like messing with him if I don't have to. Hey, Dark Soul, welcome back. How you doing? Oh yeah, these two. Oh god. Let's try them. As long as this bro doesn't get in the way, I should be fine. Oh god. Or he can kick his own friend's ass. Ow. shit. Ah, no, 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 no. I got his money at least. Yeah, these guys are a problem just because there's two of them. That's really it, though. I gotta safely build up money here so I can at least get Dragon Feet. Excuse me, stop that. Ow, fucker. Ah, fucker. Hey, what the fuck? Ah, what the hell? Really? I don't see enemies that frequently pick you up like that, so that's kind of a pain in the dick. Get out of here. I was doing pretty good the first time, getting up to $29, but I decided to spend the money on healing, which is probably not as good as just wasting your money to die and getting a new technique for it, because Dragon Kicks would be great right about now. What would you do? Where do you go? Come here, you. Oh, that guy actually has a lot of health. Alright, let's try fighting those two over on the riverside again. These two over here are optional bosses, but the reward can be pretty good for fighting them. Ah, turn around, help! If I can control which angle they can come at me from, this might be pretty easy. Oh yeah, just mash kick. Yeah, I like it. Fuck you. He can't even get up. What a sucker. Aw, man, they didn't even give me that much money. Lame. You can toss him in the river, but you don't get money for doing that. You hit your friend, you dumbass. You hold still so I can kick your ass? Ow, fuck. Oh, I've got no health left. I gotta be careful. Is there anything I can spend my money on right now that'll help me? Okay. Run away! Psych! Yeah, you better run. Throw it. I dare you. Oh. No, no, no. Let go. As long as they don't actually follow up, I should be fine. Okay, I think I have enough to buy a one technique. Let's find out. Ah, no, it's just short. I need another dollar. This is my stick now. Oh, 5 cents off, really? Okay, got it. I'm leaving. Now I can safely die after I get the dragon kicks. Yep. Nothing else, thank you. Now you actually gotta read the book, and you acquire the technique. Alright, now we can die safely. But I get this. Da-da-da. Amazing for oh! Totally predicted that. Did it on purpose. So I can safely heal. Absolutely. Don't even question that. Look at that. I just tap, 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 and they're already dead. Look at that. Oh. Getting an upgrade actually feels good. That's what Dragon Feet should have done for me in River City Girls. Ow. Wait, what the hell is hitting you, buddy? Now I just need to get some kick power to go behind that. Alright, I can do the jump kick in the air. I can do... Hi-ya-ya. Ba-ba-ba. Fuck you. Oh yeah, Moose is a repeatable boss, but he doesn't give a lot of money. Disappointing, but it's good to remember. Mouse? I don't remember if anything here is particularly useful. You know what, let's just get Chow Mein. Because Chow Mein's delicious. Man, I'm getting hungry now. I need to remember what items actually give plus kick damage, because this is like the thing I'm going to be doing for the rest of the game. Also, look how fast the attacks are in this game. Unlike River City Girls, where everything was so brutally slow. Come on, walk into this, walk into this. Yeah, yeah, eat shit. Oh, hi there. If I remember, I clear out this screen, there's another boss. There's a few more of these. Oh, come on. You really want that? Is it worth your life? Huh. I was so sure you'd defeat everyone here and the boss appears. Maybe I had to come back later? Actually, yeah, I think that's the case. How much money? $13? Okay, that's fine. We still gotta build up a little more money. Okay, good job there, buddy. Oh, fuck. Really? Filthy jerk. Okay, there is a boss in here if you clear the room. Ow. Don't run into walls, you actually deal damage to yourself like that. Ugh. At the very least, failing the platform here does not fucking kill me. If you just leave this room without defeating everybody, the boss won't appear. But if you do defeat everybody, the boss does indeed come out to beat you up. But we got Dragon Kick, so I don't think that's going to happen. I can't wait to get more moves like Acro Circus and such. That'll make things a lot more fun for clearing out teams of enemies. Also, come on. You're gonna drop your guard eventually. Oops, I didn't mean to leave. Aw. Try and pick that up, I dare you. Ah, fucker. $26. If he hit himself with both of those, I'd have been very, very amused. Ooh, the frame rate in this room kind of suffers, but old NES game, I expect it. Let's restart the boss fight because I accidentally reset it. Oops! That was bad. Oh, my kick didn't quite reach him. Okay, there we go. Defeating him gets the boss in Sherman Park to appear. Got it. Boing. Oop. I killed myself by running into the wall. Fuck. That sucks. Oh well. What can I buy around here that'll help? Oh right, where's the sauna? The sauna's really good for increasing your max health. Kasana's later in the game, if I'm not mistaken. Omni Elixir. I don't have the money for that. I think we have to get to the next town to get the stuff that powers me up a lot. Where are you? Come here. Come and get it. All right. Now we gotta go back to Sherman Park and defeat everybody. Oh right, Sherman Park is way earlier, that's right, okay. So no one's actually here yet, I'm in the wrong spot. Ow. Come and get it, bitch. How do you pick it up from that far away? What an asshole. Wait, where'd the money go? God damn it. Whatever. 27 Doolery Doos. Oh, a Merv Burger. Hello. Man, can you imagine buying a hamburger for $3 these days? What was it like back in the 80s? I have forgotten. Oh, to buy a $4 burger and enjoy it. Back in the day, food had to be good and also inexpensive. Pepper beef, please. What does this do? One of these gives you some stat. I just can't remember which one. Throw, stamina, max. Egg roll, please. Okay, I got a little more max health from that. Any health works. Ow, shit. Fucker. Oh. I did a mid-air parry of that stupid pole, and then he hits me while I'm recovering from a blog. That was rude. Aye. Oh, it's you again. $3, that's it. God. If there's one thing I can say about River City Girls, is they fixed this screen scrolling issue. But if he didn't, I'd be very annoyed. Because this is just, oh, it's an old game, whatever. Normally, if you don't have dragon kicks at this point, there's another way to make the fight with Blade a lot easier. And it involves standing on this bench and then kicking him as he gets close to you. Because for some reason, his pathfinding dictates that he needs to be on the same platform as you to hit you. But if you're standing on this park bench, you can just kick him in the face repeatedly because your attack actually covers a decent amount of depth in front of you and behind you. So you can actually just take advantage of that and beat him down.
Oh no!
Fuck. I keep trying to rush the dash there, but you know what? I need to stop. Oh, I kept all my bonus health. That's great. You guys love those chains. Good job hitting your friend with that. He tried to, like, quickly dash punch me and then run past to get to that chain. Damn it, in the middle of my guard recovery, huh? I like that he's a repeatable boss, it's just a shame he isn't worth a lot to beat up. What's this place again? Oh, Merz Burgers, right. Yeah, nothing good can come from eating here except for getting health. What's this? Alright, the pharmacy, yeah. Uh-huh. You must get tired from kicking this much this quickly. You know? You know, I'm glad he doesn't. Because it's a very handy attack to have against normal dudes. Come on. Where's the boss?
I just beat the guy in the park. There should be a dude here, no?
I guess not. Let's keep moving. Ow, fuck, really? You cut that shit out, you son of a bitch. They really want this box. Come get it. I gotta get to the next town, or the next, shopping district. God damn it. If you even touch a small corner while you're jumping up, you'll bounce off of it. Oh hey, another repeatable boss. I didn't remember that. Ooh, $42. Let's just get out of here. Oh, shit! No! Oh, I got hit in midair. Fuck. There goes all my $42. Yeah, if you're, like, at zero health, you don't want to get hit out of the air while you're trying to jump. Again, like I mentioned earlier, if you jump at a bad timing like I did, you'll get hit still, but at the very least, usually it's just you get knocked down. In this case, I actually died because I didn't have any willpower or health left. Whoa, how'd you miss? Shouldn't have jumped there. Oh no! I keep doing that! Damn it! There are so many potholes in River City. Hold still, you bitch. Jesus. Take your lumps like a man. Yeah, he's gonna retreat to get the item. Ow. You don't dash into the hole this time, Al. Ah, I need to not get hit by that. That does way too much damage. Damn it, I keep doing that. Alright, get that box now, bitch, I dare you. Ah, no. Ah, shit. There we go. If you can get up there all in one go, it's easier. God damn it. Just that box falling into place got me. God, I'm not hitting the corner, you bitch. At some point, I'll get my money back, I think. Oh god, I hate how they spawn behind you there. That's kind of rough. There's a secret shop in that tunnel, by the way, but I- ow! Ugh, fuck you. Here's the boss, finally. No! Ah, oh, fuck. I didn't mean to throw him there, that was an accident. Son of a bitch. Got a long way to go. I have yet not reached the next shopping district next. Not yet. Come here, you. That should be all of them. Fucking get out of here. Ah, don't pick up the item. Great, this is already turning into a rough situation. Really, I can't jump up from there? I'm just gonna skip these guys. The boss is nice money, but I'm also very low on health right now. Actually, since I got him in one shot... Okay, this time I'm gonna run past these guys. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit, really behind me? Again? Ooh, no. Let me out. Oh. Oh. I can't dash, why? Okay, let me through. This is the shopping district. Thank you, finally. What is Fatal Steps? I don't remember this move. What's this? The Roman cow. Ooh, lasagna. Mmm. Now I want lasagna. Pizza? What does the pizza do? Ooh, that's good. Cola float? What does that do? I'm trying to remember which of these actually sells the thing I want. None of these are gonna be very good. They're all cheap. Oh, steak! Here we go. I found the place. Was it lamb leg? I can't remember. I'm gonna try the T-bone as well. I think this one is for punch. Anyway, this is the spot. This one's punch. So that means T-bone is kick, right? Nope, that's punch. Which one gives kick? I can't remember. Yeah, agility is actually pretty good, but still. I think I have to buy shoes to get more kick. You know, obviously. But one of these gave, like, a lot of kick for not buying shoes. I guess I'll have to get more money and find out. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna look this up real quick because... I used to know how to just, like, cruise through this game, and now I've seemed to have completely forgotten. Alright. Okay, I need to buy the Texas boots, which I don't remember where they are, but I think the boot barn is in this shopping district. Otherwise, I need to find fudge bars. Is this the boot barn? Oh no, this is the toy shop. Is this it? Nope, it is not. Okay, not here. There's steak. Ah, we found the shoe store. The Texas boots are $99. Oh no. Okay, we got a while to go here. But if we can find the place that sells fudge bars, we should be fine too. Oh, there it is. Wow. Didn't realize they're that cheap. Alright, well, we gotta buy a bunch of fudge bars and the Texas boots. Alright, so the boss in this room doesn't appear until I beat the one back in the park. Ow, fuck. Excuse me. I think these guys... Ah, fuck you. Oh, what? The boss appeared? Okay. I'll take it. How? Dude, this guy's fucking fast. A lot of health, too. Okay, this is the guy who tells you about Thor. Really? Oh, Jesus fucking Christ, dude. He's so fucking fast. Okay, I still don't have a lot of money, but we can get fudge bars. Dragon Kick is nice because it can stun lock these guys if you can time it well. But also it has better reach than the punch does. Which is why I prefer using Dragon Feet over Stone Hands. Ow, I nearly killed myself there. You know, fudge does sound pretty good right now. I'm just hungry, aren't I? Is that what's happening right now? I think I can throw away Dragon Feet now that I got it. Well, that only increases my kick by one. Wow, that sucks. I guess they're relatively inexpensive, so it doesn't matter. Willpower is nice to have as well. What's my current status? 23 kick. That's not too bad. And how many of these can I buy at a time? One, two, three, four, five, six, I think 10, seven, eight, nine. Oh, 8, I guess, is the limit. Yep, 8's the limit. Okay. I mean, honestly, going for the Texas boots is absolute overkill. I think to make the game, like, pretty manageable, you only have to get to, like, 50. And I'll be at, like, 30... 31 now? Having more agility might help, though. I would probably want to get some more ribeyes. Saving up enough to get those Texas boots is going to take a bit. Ow, fuck you. Oh, what? Oh, no. You have to keep... Aw, no. You have to keep Dragon Feet in your inventory to continue using it. Aw. I feel stupid. I forgot. Oops, how'd I do that? Ah, damn it. Fuck you. Ah, come on, stop. Quit it, let me up. Oh, this sucks. At least I still have enough kick strength to defeat these guys in a couple hits. But damn. I gotta make another $27 just to get my kicks back. Ah, shit. Please turn around. Thank you. $15. Ah. I need to get some food. Nope, I'm running. Ah! Oh shit, no. No, no, no. Fuck. Oh no. Stop it! Okay, I need to recover badly. Out of curiosity... Let's see... Uh, You know what? Where is the coffee shop? Wasn't there one in this game? I do just need recovery right now. Run away! Jesus. It feels kind of silly outrunning it like that. Gosh, I don't know. Whoops. Accidentally closed that again. Damn it. Nope. I'm trying to find out where this coffee shop is. Oh, what does the donut do? Oh, what's this? Ah, there it is. Found it. Oh, did that give me max HP? Ah. What about that donut? Oh, just willpower? Wow, six of it just for that? Okay. Alright, let's go beat up some dudes to get some money. Because I want my kicks back. Then I gotta save up like $100 for those Texas boots. Oh, come back here, you bitch. You guys are so attracted to weapons, I swear. Oh yeah, the boss does respawn. I can probably beat him up for a quick injection of cash. Ow, fuck. Yeah, okay, we got my kicks back. Fantastic. Oh, shit. Okay, let's relearn the freaking tech. I don't know how he forgot it just by not having the book. Okay, let's continue. Don't give me that. Oh! Shit. Wait a second. Oh wow, he just reappears? How much does he give me? I forgot. Eh. like $2. Oh, what? I got a little more that time. Unless I just can't do math. Probably the latter. Okay, maybe around $3. Maybe 350? I can't tell. Oh no! I did it again. You know what? That's my fault. You son of a bitch, get out of here. Okay, 1240. $15.90. So $350 is what he gives me. That's still a slow grind. Okay, whatever you do, do not jump in the goddamn hole again. Oh. Shit, no. Ah! Fuck. Well, hang on. What about these guys? Now they got my ridiculous kicks. $19.40. Oh, that's like $350. No, there's two of these guys, so maybe it's gonna be faster to beat these guys up. Oh yeah, I think this is a lot faster. Do I do more damage for dashing? I think I do. Ah, things you learn. Yeah, I can beat them both before they can even start fighting me, and they're worth okay money. Kind of like that. Wow. Okay, I might be able to afford my Texas boots in good time. Okay, I found a new grinding spot. This is fantastic, actually. I just need some fudge bars to get my kick up. And then I can just beat the shit out of these dudes in like a single attack. See, this is something that River City Girls can't do, is make grinding actually entertaining. Because here, I can actually, you know, defeat enemies with relative speed. And even if I get hurt, it's not too bad. Instead of being a ridiculously slow combat that takes forever to get through. Because you can't get very strong, it feels like. And everyone has a bajillion HP. Like, that fucking sucks. You know? Ooh, I can taste those cowboy boots already. Give me them Texas boots so I can be a Texas Ranger. I wanna be a Texas Ranger and kick the shit out of bad guys' faces. Oh, this is great. Usually I avoid these guys because they're so dangerous, because there's two of them. But now, because they have to sit there and talk at me, I can actually take advantage of their stupidity and just beat the shit out of them before they can move. Man, talk about inflation, though. Some of these things I'd have to purchase for like hundreds of dollars in River City Girls. And then there's other things now, the same things in this game that I've purchased for like 20. Like, everything has gone up like 400% as far as the economy is concerned. Inflation hits too close to home sometimes, even in video games. You know? You would think, oh, video games are immune to inflation. No. River City is definitely feeling the downturn in the economy. Oh. For some reason, they died at the same time. Maybe it could because I took too long to kill the one dude. Okay, with my new pair of Texas boots and some ribeye, I think I'll be pretty much prepared to kick the shit out of the game until I get to the hot springs, and then I can build up a massive amount of willpower. Man, it's kind of like I'm the bully now, because I'm just whipping these guys for their lunch money just so I can get myself a new pair of kicks, you know? Kicks. A new pair of kicks and some steaks. Steak, steak, steak. I didn't think there'd be a good money grinding strategy in this game that didn't require a considerable amount of risk, but look at where we are. Now this is actually, even if I am grinding, this is actually not too, this isn't boring. I'm actually enjoying the power. The power. I think I've got enough now though. All right, now let's rush back to where we need to be. Don't jump in the pit. You need that money. Hey, Mohammed, welcome back. How you doing? We are playing River City Ransom because I was mad at River City Girls for being terrible. But now I'm playing a good River City game, and it's fun. Despite having a lot of the same flaws, this game at least is able to get around them by having relatively fun gameplay that isn't tedious or boring. Also, game mechanics that feel much better in general. Not mean? Because the game is slow, the jabs feel shitty, and that's like the most basic attack in your like arsenal. You can't cancel any attacks on block. Block is its own button in general. The only attack button is the one that also picks things up instead of having two separate attack buttons, like this game does, which makes it easy to avoid accidentally picking up people or items when you don't want to. And this is just generally a better functioning game. It doesn't, like, this game probably runs at 30 frames per second, knowing Technos's record with like programming games, but it feels better than fucking River City Girls. Okay, let's go get my new boots. Yeehaw. Aw, yeah. Yes, please. I'm a Texas Ranger now. Ooh, look at all that agility that came with it. You know, let's get a little more agility, just for overkill. Yeah, maybe two pieces of ribeye, and that's good. Then we need to heal. And now I'm just gonna stand in the middle of the street and cook myself some steak. Check this out. Took a break and cooked the ribeye. Ooh, I got max agility already? Okay, never mind then. I didn't need this. A little punch out of the deal, but that's okay. Wasn't there a drugstore on this street, too? Could I just go and buy, like, some Turbo Jolt now? Oh, no. Wait a second. I can buy a teddy bear. I know this gives me a decent amount of stats, but I don't remember which stat. Let's find out. While nobody was watching, Alex hugged the bear. That gave me a lot of strength and stamina, that's hilarious. Oh yeah, look at those stats now, I'm looking great. Is 63 the max kick, or is it... No, it goes higher, I'm pretty sure of that. No. I want some healing items I could take on the go, but it's whatever. Ooh. Look how fast I am now. Ah, he got interrupted by his own throwing box. That's what you get, you bitch. Ooh. Ooh, my walk speed is so good now. It feels great. It took so long to get decent walk speed in River City Girls, I swear. This feels much better. Can you? Sir? Okay. Again, this is one of the flaws of River City that I pretty much am aware of. Not having just the raw grab technique always hurts in beat-em-ups. Because it always means you gotta open people up by hitting them. Oh, I almost made it across. This should take me up. Oh, run away! Yeah, you pick that up, you bitch. Okay. So you can defeat this boss by kicking him off the level here, but I've got so much damage now, I don't have to care about that. I can stun lock him with his own guard animation by doing this. This is hilarious. Just mash kick. Oh. Ivan guards the gate at River City High. Alright, let's go. Okay, this is the last shopping center in the game. Which means, is this it? Read all about it. Oh, Javelin Man. That's a fun one, but it's expensive, and I don't have time to grind anymore. I want to beat the game. Ooh, Hack's Chicken Shack. I don't know what this place sells. But I could probably get a combo. Ew, I will eat it now. Willpower, stamina. Okay, stamina's fine. Alright, we're out. What I'm here for is all the willpower from the sauna. Where's the sauna? Karma Jolt's good. I should get some. Yes. Nothing. Karma Jolt's good for healing. There it is. Oh, it's you guys again. My new boots make you a joke. you thought you could pick on me out here? Nah, you're not getting your lunch money back, sir. Could use some sauna. Sauna might be really good. Willpower, stamina, max power. Okay, this is the shit. Because this is what makes it so he can take a lot more damage and get up from a punishment, from a pretty serious beating. This is the spot you want to get to. I think I'm gonna max out here in just a second, aren't I? I've been eating so many items throughout the game. Willpower maxed out, stamina up. Max. Okay, no, I can still get more stats. That ass, though. It was pretty funny seeing that as a kid, because has butts. Yeah, I'm still getting max power and stamina, so I can keep going in. And it's cheap. Look at how many stats you get from this. Butts are funny. Excuse me. Excuse me. Oh god, I got ridiculous allergies and I can't fight them. Oh, I think I almost maxed out on stamina. Let's find out with this last visit to Pop's Health Club. Maxed out, stamina maxed out, max power's maxed out. Okay. I don't know what it is, but the moment we got our cats a new cat tree and moved around the cat tree, my nostrils just like got completely plugged up like they are right now. I'm just like suffering here. Excuse me. Oh, that's disgusting. I don't know, whatever like dust and dirt that was in the cat tree. Probably all the like dust that cats were picking up from their own litter box. Oh, excuse me. Okay, this feels better. Yeah, it's probably them moving dust from their litter box to the cat tree. Excuse me. Ow, fuck. You sons of bitches. I don't need this stuff anymore, so I'm just gonna get- Whoa! God damn it. I got caught mid-jump again at bad timing. Okay, we're at River City High. Please? Oh, I gotta beat the boss first, right. Fucking really? The wheel? That's wheel uncool of you guys. Ow. Really? Come on, fucking stop. There he is. Let's fuck him up. Okay, can we restore what I lost now with the Karma Jolt? That would be great. There we go. I feel better. Karma Jolt's great. It also increases your throw power, I just now noticed. I don't think you have to fight the boss here at all if you just, like... Actually, no, you gotta. I forgot. Because then you're just barred from jumping on that hoop. Let me see. Yeah, I think you can't just jump on the hoop at all until you defeat the boss here. Where are you? Oh, there you are. Hi. Otis. Oh, wait, this is the janitor. So we're kicking the shit out of the janitor in universe, huh? Okay, and then the next boss is the twins. Which, by the music that plays when you're fighting them, is implied to be the Double Dragon Twins, but it isn't, actually. Oops. That was bad. Ah, dang it. Boing. Eh. Okay, now you can jump on top of this thing. And now you can reach this door over here. And you just want to skip all these rooms because they're pointless, but here's the important part. Okay, as soon as the music starts up, these guys appear. Right here? Yep, there they are. Are they really running for the weapons now? God damn it. Go over their stupid spin kick shit. Yeah. I interrupted them trying to grab the stupid sticks and kick them in the face. You'll find what you want up on the roof. You have to beat Slick? Simon, I think they call him? I don't know. Here we go. Oh shit. He made me block, and I get ran into the wall as a result. Oh fuck you, stop that. Oh, fucking... Wait, Simon says to give me a break. What's happening? My evil power is gone. Yeah, fuck you. Your evil power is a stick, and I threw it away. That's what happened, bitch. I'll admit I took a long time to beat River City Ransom today, but it's not a very long game. If I was playing decently, I could have done that in an hour. Cindy was rescued in time to finish her shopping. Har har har. And there we go. See how this game is actually fun to play all the way through, and the game isn't bogged down by slow bullshit. And also, one thing that really bugs me about River City Ransom, or River City Girls, is having to transition to other rooms isn't as easy as just walking into the door or going off the screen. You have to stand in front of the damn door and hold the attack button for a whole second to actually get the transition to happen. Which, by the way, they didn't have to make that a hold function at all if they just made it so that walking into the thing you wanted to use actually used it. I don't know why they decided holding the attack button would be more functional, but it actually makes it more tedious and stupid. Seems like a fun game for its time. It is a good game. It's still a good game now. In fact, the GBA port is even better. It's not as easy to break as the original NES version, as I just demonstrated, and there's a little more content. Heck, there's more playable characters as well. Great game. You know, when I really dwell on it, I think River City Underground was actually better than River City Girls. And I didn't like River City Underground at all. Which makes me wonder how in the hell did, again, I'm gonna say this, how did WayForward make Double Dragon Neon? And that was an amazing game. And then they make River City Girls and it's a terrible game. I don't get it. How do you mess up like that? Like, they did it so well the first time, and then the next time it's just like, duh. And they just shat the bed. They sold their soul for one game. That seems to be the case with everything they do. It happened with Contra 4, it happened with Double Dragon Neon. And then the next Contra game they made was garbage, and then the next beat-em-up they made in general was garbage. I don't know. I'm of the grounds that a lot of the things that they did in River City Girls is just stupid and not a beat-em-up type of game mechanically, because they had so many dumb things that just don't mesh with the beat-em-up genre. Enemies having billions of HP, attacks being slow and shitty feeling. Having a guard button that isn't like a reaction strikes for instant guarding. Not having more than like one attack button. Well, they had like a hard attack and a light attack. But instead, what they should have had is like a hard attack, a light attack, and like a two attack buttons and one special attack button. instead of having one light, one heavy, and one special. Or better yet, just don't have a jump button at all, and just map punch and kick to jump together like in the old games. Because they needed to use a different button entirely for picking things up, because that was the biggest issue I was having with the game, is where picking up items accidentally was a bigger hassle than trying to like do anything else. Like, if you knock down a person right in front of yourself and then somebody approaches you right in front, right on top of them, oftentimes instead of striking the people who are approaching you, you'd pick up the person underneath you. And since the pickup animation has no invincibility, you just get slapped in the face for it. Another issue is that you have these attacks that hit downed enemies, and there isn't a special input for it, like the ground and the ground pound in River City Ransom, where you just like press down on top of an I think it was a Double Dragon 1, where if you press down an attack while you're over an enemy, you'll like sit on top of them and punch them in the face repeatedly. That required a special input to do. Whereas with River City Ransom, they just want you to press the hard attack button. But the worst part about that is that when you use that that stomping attack on the downed enemies, they move. Like, they actually slide around. And because the activation distance for the grounded attack is so small, oftentimes you'll end up like doing the hard attack, and that's such a long, lengthy animation that you're very much going to hit... like, you're going to miss your hard attack because you're trying to get a stomp, and the enemy will get up while you're swinging and then hit you as you're recovering from the swing. And that's a shitty feeling. Like, just don't let me do it. Another thing they could have done is they should have made the hard attack button the one that picks things up and throws things. Sure, it already throws things, but it doesn't pick things up. The light attack does, and the light attack is already shitty as it is because it's slow, it has a long recovery time for no good reason, which no beat-em-up jab should ever have a long recovery time, ever. Like, I'll give Shredder's Revenge a pass on this because at least the jabs are different and varied in their function between characters, and so they can either be kind of bad to actually good. But you can't put the throw command on fucking the primary attack. Like, I could have had that issue during River City Ransom today while I was playing that, but you know what keeps you from picking up people on the ground? Dashing. Doing a dash attack actually prevents you from picking up people on the ground. Guess what you keep doing when you're dashing in River City Girls? You pick people up off the ground even when you're dashing. That alone could have been like the thing that made me like it a little better, because I was doing like River City Ransom things where, to avoid picking up enemies who were on the floor, I was dashing, because you can't pick up enemies or objects while dashing. But in River City Girls you can, and that's stupid and I hate it. Also, the dash attack really sucked. It really sucked. Like, when you press the dash attack, you just, like, immediately stop, and your short little elbow strike just goes nowhere. Whereas in River City Ransom, and you do a dash attack, you actually extend your hand out or your foot out for a longer period of time than normal, and you use the momentum to slide forward some. And that gives you a decent amount of reach. And of course, you get more reach depending on how long you dash for, obviously, but... even with the short dashes that I was using, that was more than enough to close a gap when enemies are trying to back away from me, and that's enough to strike them and reach them. River City Girls doesn't let you do that, because all the attacks are canned animations that have predetermined travel distances that all suck. I can only wonder how the sequel plays. Anyway, I've done enough belly aching about River City Girls for one night. At the end of the day, I'd rather play Double Dragon Neon, because that's a good game that's fun. And it doesn't feel like garbage to play. And, yeah. If anyone can tell me that River City Girls 2 is better, then maybe I'll try it. But for the time being, I don't want to bother. River City Girls just feels like it's not going to be worth it. Alright, well, that's enough bellyaching. Who's streaming? Let's see who is online right now. No one tonight. So we're going to cut it here. And, yeah, that sucks. Alright, anyway. You guys have a good night and take care of yourselves. Sorry I got off so soon after you woke up, Bahamut. You know, after you mentioned that this is the football game, that got me thinking. Maybe I should play Nintendo World Cup Soccer, because that's a fun game too. Or I should play Super Dodgeball. That's another fun game. There's like three different versions I can play too, so it depends on how badly I want to lose. Alright. That's enough for now. You guys have a good night. Thank you for dropping in to hang out with me. Sorry I did a lot of belly aching, but I felt like it was worth it. Because I need to express that these old arcade genre games were built a certain way because they worked well and they operated well for a reason. And having anyone try and change that up for no good reason just ends up throwing more wrenches into the machine for no good reason. I am repeating myself too much. Case in point, old arcade genres, they work good already. They were mastered a long time ago. Changing them messes things up. Alright, anyway, good night everybody. Thank you.